What is scanning? Scanning is basically information gathering only, but we are going on active. Okay. Next is enumeration. Enumeration is whatever we have scanned it, where we are able to log into the breach the network or not, finding out these two things. So finally, we are getting vulnerability analysis. This is the information gathering has four phases. You see, footprinting, scanning, enumeration, vulnerability analysis. Now we are in the second phase. So here, what is scanning? Okay, this is your information gathering. So what is scanning? Let us understand. Scanning means what we are talking here is set of procedures for identifying hosts, services. Okay. So what is scanning? Identify host, live host, port services. That's it. Now objective is to discover live host and IP addresses, open ports and the open ports of live host, and OS and the system architecture, what services is running, and which are the vulnerable live host, and network diagrams. Okay. So what is TCP communication flag? Do you know what is TCP communication flags? Heard about this? Don't know, right? I want to teach you. Okay, I'll teach you that. So let us start. Now we are going to. This is done. Now I told you. Every layer I'm going to add some. Every layer I'm going to add some header, right? L4 header, L3 header. In L4, I told you TCP is the protocol I'm using. TCP UDP. Now, this scanning also we will do TCP UDP ICMP. So what is ICMP? ICMP is pinging, right? Let me ICMP. Okay, you know what is the protocol we're using ICMP? Any idea? Mm-hmm. Okay, then I'll teach you them. Okay, let's start from the scratch only. I told you, right? The scanning needs some little bit theory, is that networking theory. Okay, because we are going to scan the ports, na? So this comes from networking. Start from that. Now, do you want to put this first? Copy. Paste. And next, I'm going to teach you. Now I want to send some data from one PC to another PC. So what is your L4 information, L7 protocol? L7 protocol. L7 is ICMP. Command dot. What is L7 protocols? What are L7 protocols?
Application.
What are the protocols? Tell me some protocols. So now I'm asking you TCP/IP protocol suite or OSI model. So we are going to use OSI model, but what protocols we are using? TCP/IP protocols, correct? Each layer has a function. For each function, there is a protocol standard, which is followed worldwide. Okay. The model each model application layer and function is there, presentation layer and function is there. So what is the function of application layer? What it will do, like think about it like a department. Each department has a function in the office, right? Yes, UI, user interface. That's it now. So the function is Google. The function is user interface. Alright. Let's keep it like simple like it. Now understand this. Now I am going to use one application. Let us take one application. Okay. User interface. Yeah. I take one application. Each application has multiple functions, correct? So each function has to be one standard. That standard has to be followed worldwide. Then only intercommunication will happen. IOS means what? Open system intercommunication model. What is intercommunication? I am using one application, you are using one application, but we both has to communicate. So then what you need to be more, we both what we need to do? We both must have what? Same standard. The standard is called protocol. Okay. Now understand here. Now I'm going to give and take one application. It has a function. For each function, there is L7 protocol. For each L7 protocol, we have a port number. Okay. Same way, the same function, we have a L4 protocol. And the L4 protocol, we have a protocol number. Remember these two. I'll give an example, okay? Example is, I'm going to use Chrome. Example, Chrome. What is the function of Chrome? What we can do with this Chrome application? Yeah, plain text browsing will take, okay? Plain text browsing, I'm doing. So what is the protocol we are using for browsing? Web browsing. When you type this, anything left hand side, what will come left hand side? WWW is a domain name, na? Here, left hand side, what will come? Have you seen that? I'll put this C. What is coming left hand side? So this is your HTTPS means ciphertext. Okay. Plain text means HTTP. Okay. What is the port number for this? This is L7. Remember, this is your L7 protocol. What is the port number for this? 80, just the 80. Okay. Now this is L7. Now next is L4. L4 means what? TCP. Remember, TCP. What is the protocol number? 6. Understand this, okay? Every application has some lot of functions. You take one function. For this one function, there is a standard format that is called protocol. So each protocol is having, L7 protocol is having port number, L4 protocol is having protocol number. Is this clear? Now, there are commonly used applications. What are the port numbers minimum we have to know? Like for example, Telnet. What is Telnet will do? Telnet protocol. These are like protocols, okay? So, remote login protocol. I want to log in remotely some devices. Okay. So then I need to use what? Some application. What application used to remote login? Login to a router, what application? PuTTY. PuTTY, right? So PuTTY is using Telnet. The application is PuTTY, function is remote login. Protocol is what? Plain text means Telnet. Cipher text means what? SSH. Understand? So like that, any function you take, right? There is a L7 protocol. Now, what is the port number for Telnet? 23. SSH 22. Port number. Understand this? Is this clear? Like that, so many protocols are there. We need to study. So you need to understand all the protocols where you have to go. You have to go to an organization called IANA is the Internet Assigned Numbers Authority. Okay, so IANA, if you go port number, it will show you all the port numbers. Is that no? Total 65,000 is there. Understand, no? You want to follow this? You can follow this. So now, what is this? 21, I told you, 21 is what? Sorry, 22. 23. You remember 23? 23 is telnet. You see that? 21 is FTP. 21 is FTP. 20 is data, 21 is this. Now this is your port number. This is your port number, right? Now I want to show you protocol numbers. Protocol is for IL4. Protocol number. Now protocol numbers IANA. You see now? This is your TCP is 6. Can you see this? This is the document. You want to study RFC now? Now what we are going to study now, right? We can open and study this. I'm going to teach you next topic is what? PLAX, right? So I want to learn about this protocol. You need to go do this RFC. Okay, in this only I'm going to teach you header format. Next topic. In this I'm going to teach you this part. PLAX. This is PLAX. URG. Then, this one. Okay, in this, this is what we are going to teach. This is what we are going to cover. Okay. This is the field, which is the document, authorized document to learn about protocols, RFC. This is the topic I am going to teach you. Okay, this is called PLAX. PLAX. Okay, this is called PLAX. So, this I am going to teach you. So now, where are we now? We are understanding. Now you are understanding. I am actually explaining you the L7 protocols, right? Is this clear now? Protocol and port number. Next, you are going to study presentation layer. Presentation layer has three functions. What are they? I'll write down. That is format. What is the format? PDF, MP3. For everything, there is a format, right? MP3, MP4, JPEG. For different datas, there is a standard format. Worldwide people follow that. Then only your communication will interconnection will happen. Understand? JPEG. For picture like that. This is the format. Second is compression. What is compression will do? We'll compress the size of the data. So what is the format we have? Dot zip, dot rar, dot tar. Right? So many things are there. Like that. Next is encryption. What is encryption? Changing plain text to ciphertext. Plain text to ciphertext. So protocols are TripleDES, AES, RSA, Diffie-Hellman, ECC, something like that. Keep on it. Okay. This all comes under what layer? Presentation layer. Format, compression, encryption. Three functions. Okay. Session layer. Start the session. Maintain the session. Maintain the session and end the session. Okay. Now this is your management plane. What plane? Now who started the classes now? In our could you want to attend my class? Who started the class? GAT. You went to whom you meet? who is your counselor? Parveen. So Parveen is session leader. Understand? She told me you start the class on this time, this date. She told me to finish the class on this date. She will give the start, maintain, and end. Okay. So I have to finish within that. Okay. She is the session leader now, and she will make sure that each session is separate, separate. They will not mingle. So to keep the data separate for each application. Now, your laptop is opening one application here. WhatsApp is running. Next application I opened is protocol web page. Then I opened a RFC document. Correct? Three applications I opened. How the computer knows this is coming, it has this page, this data has to come to this page only. Why it is not coming to this page? Understand this? How the same page it is coming? You got the question, right? Yes, how it is doing it? By different source port number. See, now how to see that the formula, you to see that I can use this command netman. You can go to command prompt in the PC and you can type a netstat. Okay, now see, I come here. Okay, this is I don't know to stop it. Take this. Now I type netstat. Now see this. After this, this is my L4 protocol. Okay. This TCP and this is source IP, source port number, destination domain name. Example, you can take this. You can understand WhatsApp. WhatsApp domain name, WhatsApp server domain name. Okay, convert it to IP. Destination domain name. And what is the destination port number I'm using? HTTPS 443. HTTPS means what? 443. Okay. Now this is the well-known port. You can see that. Understand, right? This is different sessions they opened for different applications. That's why data is separate. Using this different port numbers, it is keeping the data separate. Understand this? This is the session layer second function. Now, this is what we studied till now is, whatever we understood till now is lower layer. What we call that? Lower layer. Now we are going to teach you upper layer. Sorry, till now what we studied is upper layer. Now we are going to study the lower layer. Now let us do that. Now, this is your lower. Upper layer. Okay, now upper layer we have basically OS and applications. That's it, nothing else. Lower layers only devices will come. Okay, here we are actually transporting the devices. So devices may be physical or virtual, doesn't matter, but devices. Nowadays virtual also coming, but that's all. It is the function wise, it is physical or virtual, both are lower layers one. Now I'll write down the functions here. First, what is this lower layer, this transport layer will do? So what is the protocol for session layer? ACP NetBIOS. What is the protocol? Session control protocol, NetBIOS. So the protocols, if anybody asks, you can tell that. Yeah, NetBIOS. Now, transport layer protocols are TCP, UDP, ICMP. Okay, so these all are the protocols. Now, mainly TCP, UDP, ICMP is for pinging only. Okay. This one is IPv4, IPv6. I told you already. Right, IPv6. This is Ethernet. This is your cables and connectors. Right. A cable, for example, this UTP cable, like that. And connector is basically RJ45. Understand? No? MAC address is L2 is your L2 is Ethernet. Something like that. You got idea now? Now we'll go deeper on this. Now TCP, what is the function of L4 is, it is actually doing connection. See, this is important, okay? We just try to understand this, okay? Connection oriented or connection less communication. There are two types of communication. L4 will transport layer will do connection oriented and connection less communication. And reliable. Reliable or unreliable. Communication. And this is the layer he can do. what he can do is error correction and transmission and the retransmission. This is the only layer can do this. Below layers, no, they can only detect the error, but they cannot correct the error. Okay, error detection is possible, but error correction is only L4. Okay, and this is the one. This is the layer we provide port address. So where we are giving port address, where we are adding port address. That is the error detection. Lower layers, L2, L3, we can do error detection. Okay, but you cannot correct it. You want to correct, you have to send it to L4. Detection option, see, detection is CRC. If you put CRC, will detect and tell you package is damaged or not. Okay, but to correct that, you must come to L4. In the L4 protocol is TCP will correct. Okay, correct and retransmit. Now error correction and retransmission is possible only on L4. Then provides port addressing. So which layer is giving port address? L4. This port address is used in L5. Understanding, na? This port address what he gave in L4 used in L5. So because of this reason, we call him as a middle manager. Middle manager. Why we calling him as a middle manager? Because he is a powerful guy who can correct and send it again. Other guys can detect and tell him, but they can't power to correct it and send it. Understand, no? Now this is L3 is network layer. In network layer, what it does is it provides logical address. What is logical addressing? Yeah, we call this as a routed protocol. What protocol? Routed, not routing. Routed. Routed protocols are IPv4, IPv6, IPv4, IPv6. Apple talk, IPX, multiple protocols. IPX is old one, it's not used nowadays. It's appreciated. Then now feature, if you go to Macintosh, Apple machines, he uses Apple talk address. Apple talk. Okay. These all are routed. In interview, they'll ask you, what is the difference between routing protocol and router protocol? This is N plus. What I'm teaching is now, what I'm teaching now? Networking plus, basic networking fundamentals, okay? Because as a network attack, we are learning how the network is working. Then only we learn the use of these flags. Then only you understand the flag. That's why I'm teaching all this. So this is N plus question. Now it performs path determination. What is path determination? Path determination means selecting the best path, best route. Selecting the best route. We call this as what? Routing. Understand? What is the routing protocol? Report, EAGRP, OSPF, ISIS, then BGP. Okay. Next, data. Here, LLC, what it does, let me write one first. It converts packets to, or not converts actually, it's combines. Combines packets to frame, or packets to bytes and bytes to frame. Okay. First function of LLC has one function. MAC has two functions. MAC, what it does is, it is the one who does the provides the physical address. Example, if you are using Ethernet, what is the physical address in Ethernet? MAC address, correct? You know this, right? You will understand this? Prabhu, are you there? Yeah. What I was asking is, what I am asking is, do you know what is MAC address? Yeah, correct. No, that you know, right? That is given in the MAC layer, MAC sublayer. Sublayer. In data link layer, there are two sublayers are there, LLC and MAC. Okay. So the MAC sublayer is there, na? The MAC sublayer, it will give two functions. One is providing physical address and another one is performing error detection. This error detection only will add this CRC. There is one footer I put, right? Footer. Remember the encapsulation footer we added? Actually, this is header, this is footer. Check code. Okay, next. What is physical layer will do? In this layer only, data flow between where? Between host, between devices. Host, we say. Host in the form of what? In what form it is sending? In the form of bits. Bits means what? Zeros and one. Correct, na? This is the layer we will log in. Okay. So this is which provides international. See, this theory, if you are clear, no, then scanning is nothing for you. Okay. International standard, or you can international standard legibility. International standard format for what we call protocol. This is nothing but protocol. Format for cables and connectors. In interview, they'll ask you these questions, huh? It is very, very, very fundamental questions. This is, I'm teaching you because of interview only, okay? They will catch this. First question they'll ask, do you know OSI model? They're not able to answer this, they will not take you anywhere. Okay? They'll tell you, please, prepare and come. Understand? Each layer has a special function, and each function is having a standard protocols. Everybody is following same protocol, then only our intercommunication will happen. Otherwise, communication will never happen. Is this clear? Now, why are you teaching this? In this, now, I want to cover this one. Yeah, TCP. So, I'm going to take one protocol, TCP, and I'm going to talk about one particular field in that. There are multiple fields are there. I'm going to take some fields and discuss. Now, to do that, once this is done, let me know. Then I will. Okay, before that, one more thing I have to teach you. You know what is PDU? PDU? PDU, you don't know? Protocol data unit. So what is unit? What is generally what is unit? What is unit generally? If for example, you are actually buying a water bottle. How do you measure the bottle? What is the unit you use to measure the water bottle? Water. The unit to measure water. Liter, liter, half a liter, 1 liter bottle you ask, right? Same way, rice means grams, kilograms, right? Same way, how do you measure the unit of physical layer? Cable. How do you measure the unit of physical layer? Like, for example, you are getting internet connection. So, what is the speed unit you are measuring? How do you measure the speed? What is the unit? Yes. So, L1 is what? Per second, bits. Bits means you can put like, example will be like megabits per second, like this. Okay. Next, L2. Right? L2 is switch. Remember, L2 is what? Switch, for example. How do you measure the speed of a switch? Now you got one switch. Your manager is asking, is it a good switch? What is your expectation? You got it? So you say, no, sir, it's not up to my speed. So what is speed you looking for? Manager is asking. So what is speed you say? What is the unit you use? Huh? What is the unit? Kbps is basically for the wire. Interface you are talking. I'm talking about the switching function. Switching the traffic, na, one device to another, one port to another port. Switching, forwarding the packet. I'm talking about the motherboard speed. Switch motherboard. Not interface speed. Understand? See, interface may be 100 Mbps also. But switch is very slow. What will happen? It will drop all the packets. So I'm asking about how do you measure the speed of a switch? Not interface. Difference understood, right? Interface, you can say 10 Mbps, 100 Mbps, 40 Mbps, 1 gig, 40 gig, like that is interface speed. L1, that is L1. Now we are talking about L2. L2 answer is frame. Remember, this is the frame. How do you measure the frames per second, FPS? Now, same way, how do you measure your router? L3 is router. Yes. Pack PPS. PPS, packets per second. Your segmentation, you are sending the data, right? So you want to measure the speed of a transportation. You use a concept called a segment for transportation. Now, when application is sending data, how do you measure the speed of a transport? You say, how many segments you are sending, man? Segments per second. Understand? So these things, what we call? Protocol? Data unit. Whenever I say frame, whenever I say frame, you understand I'm talking L2. Whenever I say packet, generally they use the word packet, okay? Generally they use the word packet for everything, okay? But actually, when you go deeper level, this is the meaning. For each layer, there is a function, there is a unit, okay? Data, packet, they generally we use it. But actually, if you exactly use the right word, you have to use frame for L2 function, bits for L1 function, segment for transportation function. You have to use the same right in your unit. Okay, clear? That's it. This is your basics. Now I'm going to deeper on the this one. Okay. Then means you can tell me, then I will go to next. Okay, I'll copy this in the WhatsApp then. Then we'll start next. So you can make note also. Okay, now I'm going to teach you TCP. This is the topic. Actually, why I started this is I want to explain you these flags and three-way handshake. The flags and three-way handshake, okay? This is my topic, so I'm covering this part now. Now TCP is a layer 4 protocol. I start from there. Okay, TCP is a layer 4 protocol. It's a connection oriented and reliable communication protocol. Right on here. TCP. First step number one. It's a layer 4 protocol. Transport layer. Point 2. Right. It is a connection oriented protocol. What is connection oriented? Saying is connection oriented. What is the connection? Then you are saying it is a connection oriented protocol, it's a reliable communication protocol. Reliable protocol. ACK is there. Yes, very good. ACK is there. Now, third point is it's a reliable protocol. It's ACK is there. We know already. Reliable means ACK. What is connection oriented protocol mean? Before data transfer, session will be established. Session will be established. Now, what is the protocol number? 6. Protocol number is what? Which I told you. Now let us start. PC1 is sending data to PC2. It is using TCP. This application is using TCP. Okay, now how the communication happens? This is a topic called a packet walk. TCP packet walk, I'm teaching you. TCP packet walk. We are going to walk with the TCP. Packet, we are going to understand, okay? See, you want to become a hacker, no? You must know packet level knowledge. Okay? So that if you get able to understand the packet level, then only you can understand the attacks. Otherwise, the script kiddy only. So first it is going to send one packet. That is called initial sequence number, ISN 6. What is this initial sequence number? It automatically generate one number and it is sending. This packet is called a synchronization number, SYN number. So sending what? SYN equal to 6. Okay, now reliable communication protocol. Every packet, whatever the PC send, like PC1 sending, right? Whatever the packet, PC2 has to acknowledge it. Whatever I receive, I need to acknowledge it. Otherwise, next packet will not come. Understand? That is a reliable communication. I am going to acknowledge this. Who PC2 is going to acknowledge? Sir, you send 6, sir. I am going to acknowledge 6, sir. How do I acknowledge this? There is a formula. Acknowledge equal to SYN plus 1. What is SYN number? 6, right? Acknowledge number will be what? Seven. Now, this PC sent acknowledgement one packet, but PC has to receive that. No, PC1 is issued or not. PC2 want to know, right? PC1 is issued or not. So he will also create an ISN. Initial sequence number. For example, 21 he created. Okay. Then he is sending this. SYN 21. Understand? Sorry. SYN 21. Clear? Now, SYN you send, PC1 send SYN to PC2, PC2 sending SYN and ACK, SYN ACK. Now, third function, okay, now PC1 received it. Oh, okay. I got 7. 7 means yes. I sent 6, he gave me acknowledgement. Okay, SYN is acknowledged. Very good. 6 is acknowledged. Now, you want to acknowledge? Okay, take your acknowledgement. He will send it 22. Understand? These three steps is called TCP. Interview, the last previous question, huh? Interview question. What is TCP three-way handshake? 100% question asking, 110%. They're asking this question, interview question. Okay, what is TCP three-way handshake? Because attacks are based on this only happening, okay? They'll catch this person. So what is TCP three-way handshake? TCP is a connection-oriented communication protocol, reliable communication protocol. Before data transfer, it is session will be, establish a session. To establish a session, this PCs will send first SYN-ACK and ACK. Okay, this three steps is called TCP three-way handshake. Once the SYN-ACK ACK is happened, then the session will be established. Now, I want to transfer the data. Now the real transfer starts. Understand? Now the real transfer starts. Data transfer starts. Okay. Now. First, it is push. Push means it is sending data. Who is sending whom? PC1 is sending to PC2. Then for the push, it will give a ACK. ACK means yes, I received your data. And again, PC2 is pushing his data. Then ACK. This is the data. Push ACK like that. You go. So this process, this flow is called actually data is flowing in this entity. Data flow. Data transfer is happening. Understand? PC1 is pushing the data, for every push there is acknowledgement. PC2 is pushing the data, for every data, PC1 is giving acknowledgement. Now data transfer happened, data is got transferred. Next step, again, PC1 will say, I want to finish the communication. You say, okay, no problem. I'll finish. Now again, what happened? First, he will say fin. Fin means what? Finish. And he will give what? Sorry. Fin. Then he will give finac. Finac means yes, sir. Finished. Okay. Finac clear. Next, he will give ack. Yes. Then session closed. Understood this? Now I put SYN, ACK, push, PIN. You seen these words, right? Yeah. These all are called flags. What is a flag? Flag is nothing but type of communication. In TCP header, we have multiple fields are there. See, I'm going to add TCP header. No, this is data. Data what I'm adding, TCP header, right? This is my TCP header, L4 header. In the TCP header, right, multiple fields will be added. Example, starting from source port, destination port, right? Header length is 20 bytes. Remember, size of the header. Header length, protocol, so many things will be added. In that, main things are flags. In the flags, we'll add 6 flags are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 flags. That's where I don't have. So what this flag is, 0 on 0 1 0 1, you take like this. So whenever you see this 0, you understand flag is down. 1 means on, like that. So URG flag. The URG flag is on, the data is urgent. Okay, SYN flag is initiation is starting. Starting new section is going to start. Initialization. Acknowledgement is coming, you know that. Push is pushing the data, right? Finish means finishing the data. Now, I want to reset the whole session. Reset. For the different flag. By seeing this flag, application understands for this function only, this data has come. So based on that, it will work. Understand? Generally what happened? Ping will be blocked. What will be blocked? Ping will be blocked by firewall. Ping will not be allowed. Now I want to scan the traffic. I use these flags. As a hacker, I use flags. So TCP will be open, right? TCP cannot block. Understand? TCP will be open. So to understand the scan, understand the ports are open or closed, ping will not help me. Instead of ping, I use TCP these flags. That is our techniques, scanning techniques. Na? How to do scanning techniques? Using different flags. Okay. So I know that this flag goes, this reply will come. If this reply is not coming, that port is open. Like that. I'll understand. So in the scanning techniques, I use different flags for knowing the open ports. What is? This is the one they are talking here. Can you see that? Urgent flag, pin flag, reset, push, act, sync, three-way handshake, TCP termination. Why we are teaching all these things in the basic itself? Because when you go to the lab, there you must not have any doubts. Yeah. Because the tools are there. NetScan, Tool Pro, Postinato, Vanpiller, Packer. These all are packet crafting tools. Plan for Roach Fire. Now? How many tools are there? You want to know, write down means I can write down 100 tools. Okay. As I told you, right? Don't worry about the tools. See that function is happening, I'm happy. Now you give me all these details, I'm okay with it. Any tool you use, that doesn't matter for me. Got it, huh? But you must be giving all these details to me. Got it, right? Don't spend time more on one tool you learn properly. Full focus. See that you're able to do it. Like Nmap is there, Nmap. Nmap, if you learn, very good. No? This is Nmap, is there, right? These are the tools. Nmap, HPing, SuperScan, PRTG, MIA, MegaPing, so many tools are there. NetScan, four tools. Learn one tool, Nmap, and SuperScan. There are some tools. HPing is good. Packet crafting. What is packet crafting? We can exact the flag, what flag I want. I can make this flag on and send it. That's what I call packet crafting. I will say, send with acknowledgement flag. Now, firewall will see acknowledgement. Now, what acknowledgement firewall will think? When I send with acknowledgement flag, what firewall will think? If somebody is replying back, but no. Now, you say, when you're entering the gate, you're saying the man, you say that I came here to give this back. I collected, I'm giving back. They will allow you, right, inside, because you are coming back to give back. That's it. Okay, so where are we now? We are just started. Okay, so we are talking about the different tools here. There are the tools available. We'll be doing NMAP, HPing, all these tools for you. Packet crafting tool is very important. You have to know one packet crafting tool in scanning. See, there are standard techniques will be there. You can select this technique. You can go and select this. These are techniques are there. See, that's stealth scan, TCP full connect scan. Different types of scanning will come. But that is actually, we are, it is standard available technique. But if you know really how to craft a packet, then you are actually no need to go for this automated scanning. What is automated scanning are there? There are some techniques are there. We call it as self scan, inverse scan, like that. So there is nothing but different flags they will use. Based on the reply and the flag, they will come to know that okay, this reply is coming, is this port is open. Understand? So packet crafting tool is very important for you, which we can create our own flag and send it. Okay, the one tool you have to learn. Then we have techniques available. There are pre-built tools are there. We'll just use the different flags they will put, and they will find and tell you the ports, opening open ports. Okay, now first overview: ICP scanning, ICMP scanning, TCP scanning, UDP scanning. So three types of scanning is there. In the TCP is more detailed. Okay, TCP we have open TCP scanning methods are there: full scan or TCP connect. Full scan means, you know what? Three-way handshake. All three-way handshake will happen. Then SYN, SYNAC, ACK. Okay. Then half scan means stealth scan. Half scan means half stealth scan. Half scan will happen. Inverse will happen. Flag. Just sending the flag. Just sending the fin. Just without any flag you are sending. XMAS. Different methods are there. We go deeper on this. Then third party, the methods IDLP, PAD scanning is there. Different methods are there. We'll see on them. First, ICMP, you know, it is PCA, ICMP, core reply division. There doesn't come to know the link with any interfaces up or the IP up or down, right? Ping swipe is, you know, what is ping swipe is? You can just select the range and it will run ping one by one IP and tell you which are the IP live host is there. Okay. We have tools like ping swipe tools are IPs, angry scanner, holocaust. We use actually angry scanner, holocaust. So it will just ping from one range, whole network, can use the whole network in ping and tell you which are the live host. Understand? Okay. Then we have full scan. Full scan means what? SYN, SYNAC, ACK, and reset. So reset means again remove the which, please log out. Understand? Login and log out. But by this, what you are doing? By doing this, you come to know that this port is open. Understand?
Okay.
See, understand why we are using TCP scan is ping is not working. Ping is blocked by firewall. But TCP will not be ever blocked. Using these flags, I'll come to know that TCP three-way handshake is happening in this server. So then I can tell them, boss, attack. You got it. SYN flood attack will work. You got it, na? So I want to do SYN flood attack. SYN flood means only SYN I'll send, okay? And not give acknowledgement. Correct, na? DOS attack. You know this, right? Yeah. So SYN I'm sending. So what will happen? This guy will not be able to acknowledge. Wait for acknowledgement. Open the session and wait for acknowledgement. Half session will open and wait. It will never you get acknowledged. Understand? That I can to do that. First I will check this full scan is possible or not.
That I do.
Which one, sir? I didn't understand. Can you repeat that?
Wait for the
Can I? Tell me again. Continuous ping, is that TCP, three-way handshake. No ping. Ping is this one. This is ping. This is ping. This is I'm sending a TCP packet. Ping is ICMP. ICMP protocol. Echo reply. DOS attack. Here I'm just seeing this port is open or not. How? Using this PLAX. Not by echo reply. I come to know that session is open means port is open. Right now? Session is not opening means port is closed. Something like that. Understand? Now half means what? I'll send SYNAC reset. That's it. SYNAC, I'll give reset. Not you act. This is half open. Half scan. Why we are using different methods, you know? Somewhere firewall will escape. We can escape from firewall. That is the reason. We have different methods. You got it? Confuse the firewall. Somewhere firewall will have some confusion and it's allowing inside. That's the reason. So now see, I'm doing inverse flag. I'm sending fin, urgent, push, null. No response. Means open. Fin, urgent, push, null. I said no response is coming. It is closed. Got it? When I'm sending this flag, no response means the port is open.
No response means
open. Like that. Different parameter coming. Now see, XMAS means what? Fin, urgent, push, I'll send. No response, open. Fin, urgent, push, reset, closed. Understand? You got it, no? Now, just to give acknowledgement, we'll give reset. Then, port is open. Then, fragmentation identification number. You remember this word fragmentation I told you? Dividing into multiple, small. That identification number they'll use for scanning. UDP scanning, you know. Just UDP port is open or closed. No response, open. Unreachable, closed. Okay. There are some protocols are there. You just connect that, it will get automatically get configured. PNP we say. PNP means plug and play. What is PNP? Plug and play. So these protocols, no, we will, if these protocols are available, we use this protocol and find lot of information. If the devices are allowed to open, generally they will block. If they open for plug and play, right? They don't want to configure, they automatically want to get configured. Then we use what? This one. Then, what is the solution? How do you protect from this? Use firewall and IDS. That is a countermeasure. Understand? We have higher end firewalls are there, which we can, it will understand each and everything in TCP handshake. It will know knowledge of TCP. Firewall will know. First, you send SYN, no. Next, you need to receive SYNAC. No, you are sending again reset. I will not allow you inside. It will say. Firewall will say. Understand? It's called the DIP. Deep Packet Inspection. Next generation firewalls are there. They will do it. Understand? It will play like that. Now next. How do I bypass the firewall then? How do I bypass the firewall? How do I escape from firewall and IDS? One method, you know what? Easy method I'll tell you. One method is break the data into 10 packets. Okay. Don't send in a single packet. Then firewall will not allow. Small 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 send it. No, firewall will think something else if you allow. Understand? See, you want to send one machine gun, right? How do you send machine gun? You send full machine gun as it is, no, it's difficult. You put small pieces in a banana, all these things you put, vegetables put and send. You see this movie, no? Surya movie was there. Surya movie. You see that? You bring a full gun in vegetables. That is actually fragmentation. Same way, the firewall will allow, if you fragment, you send it. Full packet you send, it will capture. Boss, this is the wrong device, wrong packet, it will not allow. Detect also. That is one technique. Understand the technique? Same way, source routing means, I will use the source, what source I want to allow. I will change the source IP. Spoofing, you know, right? IP address spoofing, like that. And I'll decoy. Decoy means I'll use somebody's IP address. Understand, no? Somebody's IP address I'll use. Decoy. Spoofing. Power. Understand? I'm playing with the routing technique. Then, there are different methods are there. How to do it? and countermeasures. Countermeasure is what? Use multiple protocols, encrypt the data, do not allow IP-based authentication, use random sequence number, filter both ingress and egress. These are the countermeasures for IP spoofing. Understand? What is proxy server? Instead of you, somebody is going to your work. That is one countermeasure. Understand? No. Don't allow them directly. Don't allow directly the user to go. Put one proxy server. Through them, it will allow. They make a proxy chain also. Okay? There are tools are available. Grub suit we generally use. In our car is there. Grub suit is there. These are the tools available for proxy. We in labs we do grub suit multiple times. Grub suit is a famous tool. And for mobile also we have proxy. Anonymizer is there. Remove all energy from the user computer. These are some tools are there. Alexa tails. We find out the censorship. Anonymizer of tools. The tools are there. Now what is banner grabbing? Collecting the information by only by the banner. Okay. Now you send some information. Reply is coming. In the banner it is saying it is what version. All the details. Okay. That you grab. Remember. When a reply is coming, I will see the banner. In the banner, lot of information will be there. This is coming from this with this OS, this person, you know. That's called banner grabbing. Understand? Network diagrams, you know, you can use the tool called App Manager. Which one, sir? Information gathering, yes. Information gathering. See, all of you is gathering only. Your banner grabbing is you are actively doing with the system. Footprinting is where you went and you came out. I'm going that foot and taking the footprint. Like I went to Google, I went to some Google search. I went to a website. That website I'll go and type your information. I logged in Facebook. I'll go and collect information from Facebook. Passive, correct now. And the information is active or passive is more on without technical. Here I'm using techniques. I'm running tools. And collecting, understand? The difference is in scanning we are active, fully active, direct interaction started. But mainly footprinting is no direct interaction. You can do direct also, but the main thing is understand their goal is different. Their goal is what? Understand the posture. Your goal is what? To get open ports. Understand? Services. The goal you have to remember. Technique, same technique also you can use, doesn't matter. If you reach the goal, okay for me. See every phase we have network diagram, correct? There also we got that network diagram is just on paper and taking and writing two servers. Here I'll use a tool, App Manager. The tool will give me the details because you are actively communicating with the talking with the network now. Difference understand? In footprinting, we will also do a network diagram, but that is just understanding that okay, there's a server is there, one IP is there, you write down. But here I'm using a tool and discovering and putting in there. Okay. Now in the pen test, what happens? Report with close to unused ports, services, banners, configuration errors, and firewall scanning all these things. Report with that. Then step by step, host discovery, port scanning, IDS, IPS, right? Banner grabbing and OS footprinting. Understand this fingerprinting, banner grabbing is coming from the reply, from the OS. Banner reply. Understand, no? From the OS communications, data communication, I'm capturing and finding the by banner, I'm understanding what OS it is running, what is the version it is running, all these things. Network diagram finding and submit to management. Okay, no? We have four labs here, HPing, NMAC, network scanning, Wireshark. So tomorrow we'll start from one by one lab. Okay? So tomorrow we'll finish this lab, then we'll go to enumeration. Okay. Display is fine for you. What I'm covering now, this methodology is okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So tomorrow, first again, 15 minutes. I will teach. I will ask questions from. I will share this scanning now. Okay. I'm just.
Monday is not tomorrow.
Oh, tomorrow you're not coming. Right? Thursday you're not. You're off. Yeah, I told you. This week you're busy. Correct. The next class, I'm sharing this this one to you. The next class when you're coming on Monday. Okay. Q&A will be there. Your interview questions will be there. Be ready for the interview question for these three modules up to scanning. Okay, up to scanning, you prepare ready. You can do that. Then I'll start the lab. every day 10 to 15 minutes or maximum 30 minutes also will go, depends on the your learning speed. So then I will cover a maximum entry questions, review all the modules, till what all modules we study. Okay, fine, right? So Monday 9 o'clock we'll meet. Okay, take care, nice day, have a take care, bye, take care, bye.